Bizarre Brain Comix. Crumb, crumb, the old stew bum. Hup, hup, hup. Keep on trucking, keep on trucking. Hello, 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 hello. Gary here for Bizarre Brain Comics, where I like to talk about comics of all kinds, break down the artwork, and try to talk about them as art and literature. Today, I want to talk a little bit, not so much about this particular comic, but about the creator. Here, this is R. Crumb's Hup 2. And this is, I'm just going to talk about one story. It's probably the only story I can talk, I can show the artwork on and on YouTube. This is Hup number 2 from Last Gasp Eco Funnies from, I think it was 1987, by Robert Crumb. Yeah. Now, Crumb was an interesting character and a rather bizarre character. So let's see what I have here in my big book of knowledge. I'll talk about Crumb more at another time, but I'll tell you a little bit about him. He's born Robert Crumb. He's an underground cartoonist and musician, born and raised around Philadelphia, and later grew up in Delaware. And he has 4 siblings, 2 brothers and 2 sisters. He drew artistic inspiration from such sources as Walt Kelly, who did the Pogo comic strip, and the Fleischer Brothers animation studio, who did stuff like Betty Boop, Popeye, and the 40s Superman cartoons. And as well as magazines such as Harvey Kurtzman's Humbug and Mad Magazine. And Crumb started his artistic work in 1962. I mean, that's professional. He had been drawing his entire life. Both him and his brothers started working at American Greetings Card Company in Cleveland, Ohio. He got some of his comic stuff published in 1965 by Kurtzman's Help magazine. And just as he moved to New York City to work with Kurtzman, Help ceased publication. So he worked for Topps Trading Cards for a while. And he got into doing very adult, drug, and sex-oriented comics for alternative and underground publications, a variety of hippie-type newspapers. And in California in 1967, he published what some consider to be the first true underground comic book, Zap Comics No. 1. Actually, No. 1 was No. 2, but on the first, he did the first issue, and something happened, and the artwork disappeared. Many, many years later, the artwork showed up again, and so he went ahead and published Zap Zero, because it technically took place before number 1, and that's all that kind of background I'm going to talk about here. We'll talk more about his art. Now, Crumb's been married twice, and he lives in France now. As far as I know, he still lives in France. His wife made him move. Well, it's better to talk about Crumb when you're looking at Crumb stuff. So, let's get to Hup, Hup, Hup. Okay, so if you are somehow unfamiliar with Robert Crumb and his art, This is a sample here, and this is some of the tamest stuff available. That's why I did this particular story that we're going to talk about, is because he had so much, tend to put so much graphic sex and violence, and this has violence in it. But fortunately, in this particular story, all the grotesque sex stuff is on one page, so I'm able to hide it. But Crumb, of course, he drew some weird stuff. Totally weird stuff. But he truly is a great artist. He's had his stuff published and sold, and art shows of his work exhibited at art galleries and the like, and probably undoubtedly in museums. But you get, just get a little taste of here of some of his stuff. He has very self-deprecating humor. He makes fun of himself and his proclivities and some of the stuff. And I guess when he was working at American Greetings Cards, his art director and stuff had him try to make stuff more cutesy. And so that followed through a lot with his artwork, later artwork. And it reminds me, and you can see a sample here, and this isn't too bad, this is just his regular artwork. He did some stuff with, written by other people, primarily or maybe almost exclusively, Harvey Pekar. Here's the one volume of the Complete Crumb. They've had, I don't know how many volumes, this is number 9. And try to find something that's not too bad. And I can't. I'd have to look for. And I wanted to show you one other thing. I'll be right back. Okay. Here it is. I just forgot to get it with my other stuff. This is the sweeter side of R. Crumb. And this as an example here. You can see some of his very realistic very realistic drawing artwork. He's good at doing portraiture and the like. Here, some you can see. It's just some beautiful realistic artwork. Crosshatch, pen and ink, and he did a lot of stuff with musicians. These are all mostly from photographs of locations in France where he lives, or maybe he did them live. I don't know. Some of these from his sketchbooks, just stuff he's done live. A little thing he did about his daughter when she was little. Oh, this is a neat one. His wife Aline, and he was doing some experiments with brush and ink, because he normally uses pen and ink, technical pens. And you see, it's just some beautiful, realistic work. Now here in Hup, and I chose this one for, this is, at least this particular story and this cover, is his attempt at doing a mainstream type, superhero type comic story. And which is reflected in this, even though he really likes big, bulky, and muscular women, strong women, and it is reflected in virtually all the women he draws. And then he has a little bit of pretty graphic violence depicted there. Okay. Now, he has a little introduction here in the inside front cover. And this character here is supposed to, the fictitious editor talking to the reader. And this is a character who is intended to be a combination of Stan Lee and Jim Shooter, both of Marvel Comics. And they called him Stan Schnooter. Okay. Then on to the story, the mighty Power Fems versus the horrible homunculi. And these are the three main characters, Ashley, Kirsten, and Sha, or is that Ska? Sha. And there they are, they're big, beautiful, muscular, young, healthy college girls. And they're in the gym working out, of course. Of course, also eating snacks. And these girls have no superpowers. They're just extra tough and strong and giggly. Real nice figure here. And he did some of the... a little bit more unusual page layouts, which he's good for anyway. But he also does... depending on the type of story. So this is kind of imitating some of the page layouts of some mainstream comics. Now you can see these young ladies are rather sexy. They're getting a beep, beep, beep. Oops, there goes my beeper. What now? So young lady here working out. And remember, this is before cell phones. They make the call. And okay, gosh, we're on our way. So no time to explain. Put on your shoes. Put your shoes on, Shaw. We got to get to the DA's office like this minute. So they get out and they run, just passing the cars right up. Now, one thing I wanted to point out that at this time he was now Crumb normally almost exclusively draws with pen and ink or technical pens. And he was doing some experimenting with brush and ink for drawing rather than just the solid blacks. And you can see here in some of these lines, he was done with brush and ink. Gives it nice, thick and thin. Just makes it visually interesting, which is a lot like most mainstream comics. He was trying to make it look more like mainstream comics. So the girls, they're just all goofy. They crash through the door. The DA tells them about, there's some kind of, here, kind of, the DA, but he's kind of a mystery, half in shadow. He's the mysterious boss person. And there are bomb threats against Wall Street or whatever it happens to be. Terrorists, this going to blow up the stock exchange. So they don't know what to do. They're going to go check things out. Well, while they're in there talking, here's this little squirrely guy, who is apparently the janitor. He's listening in. Well, no one even notices him. He sneaks out. I better get to the hideout and tell the boys about this development. We just might be able to turn them girlies to our advantage. maybe. And the girls head off, and there they are down in front of the stock exchange. And of course, they're in their workout stuff, so they're kind of like a superhero type costume. They're tough and they're well known. And they spot this one of the homunculi who just doesn't fit. He's just a real squirrely looking dude who is probably the guy that was right there. Yep. And they spot him, and he goes, he's got a bomb. Oh, God, run, eek. So then he runs down. We don't know whatever happens to that little bomb. I think it's a fake. And he dashes into this little hole in the wall. Grab him, halt. They squirm their way in there, and whoop, what happens? They pull the girl in. Something happens. And the next one, she crawls in. And here we see a whole bunch of these little squirrely guys. They are the little homunculi. Use a squirt gun. Shove that in the girl's mouth and it's drugged. Squirts that in her mouth and drugs the girls. Then does that to the third one. Now there they are. They're all doped up. Go woo, woo, woo. Ooh, the colors, the patterns. Ooh. Now, these are the kind of characters, these little homunculi, Crumb likes to use once in a while for sometimes to depict his own inner depravity. And they're all just like that. And of course, these girls represent the epitome of womanly beauty to him. And I gotta admit, they're all beautiful women. He's a great, beautiful artist. The storytelling, visual storytelling, is fine. His, the image of the girls are cutesy, which is common, but moderately realistic. Even though the characters are small and grotesque, it's done moderately realistic. And then they okay, so the homunculi sit the girls in front of the TV, and they start playing some real mind-bending videos to kind of brainwash them. There's an old saying, those who don't know history are doomed to repeat it. Words of wisdom. So let's go back a few hundred years, way back to the days of old, when knights were bold, and the workers and peasants were ground under the heel of oppression. Da 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 da, the whole thing. They're talking about that. And now here is the page that I can't show you. Because it's, but fortunately, it's all only one page. It has some very graphic sexual stuff. So we'll skip that, because it's not really. Okay, here the girls are. They're all brainwashed. He says, we must seize the time, sisters. Let's deliver a decisive blow against the cruel bosses. And they're all kind of brainwashed. And they go, oh, we're all right. Yeah, and they go in and they get into the, see, very, very dynamic. Dramatic and dynamic way they make their entrance in at the stock exchange and nest of vipers, and they're very superhero-ish, and they go in and they start tearing the place apart, just like Samson here smashing the pillars. Oh my gosh. And all the big businessmen are horrified in terms of what's happened with the mighty Power Fems. And so, oh, there's only one thing we can do. So they bring out lots of money to try to bribe them. Stop, here's all this money. Oh wow, all for us? Think of all the stuff we can buy. Yeah. Hey, then they come out of their drug stupor. It brings them out, and it really pisses them off. Those creeps. Now I'm really angry. So they rush back to the homunculi's hiding place, crash through the wall, and just literally pound them into hamburger. And this is where the art is very graphic. The violence is very graphic. And of course, the whole thing is all humorous, not to be taken seriously at all. And the girls are, the homunculi have been stopped, and the girls are having a good old time. Ooh, yuck, look at my boots. What a shambles. Boy, do we need showers. I'm glad it's finally over. Hey, I love you guys. Huggy bears. I better not show that one. It's not too bad, though. So that is that story. And it's just a taste. Just a taste, an introduction to some Crumb. Now, in 1995, Crumb was the subject of an Academy Award-winning documentary, which is available. It's probably streaming on something, and here it's available on DVD. This is the Criterion Edition, Blu-ray. And hard to believe it's been almost, well, pushing 30 years when it, you know, it was 95, so this is, so it's, what, about 26 years, 27 years since that movie came out, which is kind of funny because it's been as long or longer, was longer since that movie came out than the time that they're talking about Crumb's beginnings. And of course, it shows a lot of his very graphic artwork. And so it is intended for adults. And there's another documentary, which is about underground comics, called Comic Book Confidential. I don't have a copy of it. I would like to, though. And since it's about underground comics, it does feature, Crumb features prominently in that. And that's quite interesting and a lot of fun. If you can find that, I recommend it. That's probably from the 80s. But here you see here. This is a Crumb drawing of himself. Most of his stuff is that's features, and he does a lot. Has done a lot of autobiographical or semi-autobiographical stuff, which he makes fun of himself. He's on that same one. This is he works with his wife. And this features both Aline and Sophie, their daughter, who's now an adult, and she draws comics too. And you just can't say enough. You can't get enough. There's just so much Crumb material available out there. I don't know what's available new in print and what's some other stuff I do want to talk about another time. But here, oh yeah. You can see, here's a drawing he did of his wife. Very realistic. And someone else. Another lady. So you can see he's very competent. More than competent. I would say excellent. So, good at page layout. Good at, great at anatomy. Even though it is usually exaggerated. Sometimes to the point of grotesqueness. Some young ladies he knew in high school or went to school with, he may not have actually known them. And that's about all I really have for Crumb right now. Remember, all of Crumb's material is adult in nature. So, I recommend it just for adults or at least older teens. But I wanted to show you his artwork. Give you a little taste. Some of the stuff is downright bizarre. A lot of it was drug influenced. So, but okay, that's all I've got for Crumb. I hope you enjoyed it. Like, share it with anyone else that you know who likes comics. And remember, comics are art.